Now, what a difference a few years make. Exactly 4 years ago, Mayor Bloomberg came into our community at an event hosted by the Spartan Community Federation on Ocean Parkway, and he passed his trusted deputy, Dennis Walcott. Where is that deputy, Mr. Walcott, right over there? With the responsibility of working with the Jewish community's representatives to bring every possible legal resource into our yeshivas. And so when our David Niederman, David Rubel, and I subsequently met with Deputy Mayor Dennis Walcott a few weeks after the mayor made that announcement, we met to begin the process of allowing yeshivas access to Title I remedial services through third-party vendors. And we knew then that it would be a long road. However, that long road was a relatively smooth one, and that's because the mayor, the deputy mayor, and the executive director of the Bureau of Non-Public Schools, Karen Zeta-Monsher, were absolutely committed to making this happen. And I want to be crystal clear. Without the mayor's direct support, we would not be standing here today announcing the launch of a Title I remedial services to over 14,000 yeshiva students in 46 yeshivas. Folks, we're talking about over $24 million worth of instructional services that will be going to struggling yeshiva students this year alone. So first off, thank you, Mayor Bloomberg, for always putting our children, make that all of New York's children, ahead of politics. Also, I must recognize the work of our fellow non-public school committee members, especially the Board of Jewish Education, led by the indefatigable Rabbi Dr. Marty Schloss, who, despite being a Renaissance fan, is still a remarkably good man.
What's that? Go Sharks?
My mother says that she never remembers us going to Fenway Park or Braves Field. But eat your heart out, I went to day camp with Warren Spahn's daughter.
Wow. Also Boston.
Also Boston. Nobody Braves. Remembers. The Boston Braves were in Boston until I was 11 years old, which was 53. And then Joe Torre played his first year. Go Carolina. Joe Torre played his first year with the Braves, but in Milwaukee. That's the year he played.
That's pretty impressive. We're happy to hear that you're rooting for New York now. We also want to thank our dear friends at Agudas Yisrael, led by the esteemed Rabbi Chaim Douglas Weibel. And I also need to recognize my local partner who actually just walked in, Rabbi David Niederman. And it looks like Rabbi Niederman and I are the political odd couple. I'm the Ashkenaz official lawyer, and he's the Hasidic rabbi, as you can see. As a hobby, the rabbi negotiates with governments like Yemen to release Jews whose lives are endangered. And as a hobby, I negotiate with New York State government in order to try and bring maximum resources to our yeshivas. So the rabbi teases me about how easy my hobby is relative to his hobby. But with respect, Rabbi, I know that negotiating with Presidents Ali Abdullah Saleh must be difficult, but I think the mayor can vouch for me on this. Negotiating with Shelley Silver is no walk in the park. Seriously, together with Rabbi Niederman, with the help of our public policy guru, David Rubel, we spent thousands of hours working in close proximity to make this dream of providing remedial services to yeshiva children a reality. Which brings me back to our event today. Yeshiva parents are constantly struggling to make ends meet. The cost of a dual curriculum for each yeshiva student easily tops $10,000 a year. So why do parents do it? Why do they make the sacrifice? Of course, the simple answer is because our religion mandates it. Orthodox Jewish parents simply are not allowed to send their children to public schools for religious reasons. But it's more than that. These parents are sacrificing because they believe that in this country, the key to success is education. And here at Barkai, they take that belief to the next level. Not only do they follow the nearly 2,000-year-old guidance of the Pirkei Avos, the ethics of our fathers, where Rabbi Ben Haihai advised that, quote, 5 years of the age for the study of Scripture, 10 for the study of Mishnah, 13 for the obligation to observe the mitzvahs, and 15 for the study of Talmud. Here at Barkai, not only are they teaching all of the Torah, they combine it with the finest education in arts, English, literature, math, sciences, and extracurricular activities, because they believe that all of these subjects are in fact God's wonders. And that is why the parents readily sacrifice. In the words of the same rabbi in the epics of our fathers, he says, L'chum Sara Agra, according to the pain is the reward. That's right, 2,000 years ago they were saying this, no pain, no gain. And the Rambam, Maimonides explained that this is directed to the students, many of whom are sitting right here today. And what the Rambam says is that as a student, you could study in a subject and you could get very concerned and you could be struggling, but you shouldn't worry, because the more you struggle with your story, with your studies, the more you will be rewarded in the end. And kids, if you don't believe me, all you have to do is look at the mayor. He's living proof. The mayor grew up, as you just heard, in a middle-class family and worked hard to get where he is today, at the pinnacle of business and political success in the United States of America. And I just want to leave you with one final thought. While I was reading through the Perkei Avos this morning, there was one other phrase in the same chapter, chapter 5, that struck me. Yehuda, the son of Tamar, would say, be bold as a leopard, light as an eagle, fleeing as a deer, and mighty as a lion to do the will of your Father in heaven. Ladies and gentlemen, I know one man who personifies these traits, our mayor. So it's my privilege to introduce you to the man who is bold as a leopard, light as an eagle, fleeting as a deer, and of course, mighty as a lion, the leader of our great city, Mayor Michael Rodriguez.